Careblazer, let's talk about vision changes that happen in dementia. Basically, how dementia changes how a person sees and experiences the world around them. What I often hear from Careblazers is that their loved one just went for a vision test, their vision is fine, or their loved one got a prescription that works, but their problems seem to be worsening. They still seem to be having problems seeing the environment. Things don't seem to be getting better, despite the eye exam saying everything is fine. It's easy to assume that vision changes are just a natural fact of getting older. But when it comes to dementia, it goes beyond the eyes. In dementia, the vision changes are greatly impacted by the brain's ability to process and understand what's being seen. So we'll talk about in this video today some of the common changes we see in dementia and also some of the less common changes that can be seen, how it differs from normal aging, and what you can do to make life safer and less confusing for your loved one. Let's start first with the common vision changes we see in dementia, and that is a decreased visual field, sometimes referred to as tunnel vision. This is basically where the person with dementia can only see what is directly in front of them. It's going to be easier for them to totally miss what's off to the side. This might be noticeable even as they eat a plate of food. They might miss things that are on the side. They might miss the side plate. It might often be seen as them bumping into objects when they're walking because they don't see what's in their peripheral. Basically, the visual field that we are experiencing starts to narrow down into a tunnel and shrinks dramatically for many people with dementia. So the next time your loved one is wondering who keeps moving my stuff, or maybe even they seem startled when you come into their field of view, it could be a sign that their visual field has shrunk. Another common visual change is having to do with depth perception. This is where the person with dementia starts to have trouble accurately judging how close or far away objects are. You might notice that they are more hesitant around stairs, that they might reach for a cup and miss it, that they might misjudge a step. They might think that the floor is uneven, even though it's not. This is happening because the brain's spatial processing areas are impacted. So something as simple as pouring a cup of coffee can lead to significant messes as they miss the cup. Depth perception may decrease slightly for all of us as part of normal aging, but in dementia, it's much more significant. Now, another way that vision changes in dementia is through color and contrast sensitivity. Basically, a white plate on a white tablecloth might seem to just disappear, or dark rugs on the floor might look like holes in the floor. In normal aging, some color loss can be normal, especially with blues and greens. That's okay. But in dementia, the brain's visual pathways are disrupted. So even with perfect eye health or perfect prescription, the color contrasts seem to blend together. So at lunchtime, they may be wondering, where's my sandwich? Because it's blending in so clearly to the white plate, which is why you may have heard the common advice to use a brightly colored plate with somebody who has dementia. The bathroom might even be an issue as they can't find the toilet seat. So maybe putting on a brightly colored toilet seat cover can help in that area. Another thing that's commonly tested for when somebody goes into get dementia testing, a full neuropsychological testing, is something called visual agnosia, which is basically trouble recognizing objects and faces. It's not about their eyesight. It's about their brain being able to understand what they are seeing. A person might not recognize their own reflection in the mirror. They might use their pen as a toothbrush. In normal aging changes, we might have difficulty finding the name for a word. It might be on the tip of our tongue, but we eventually come up with it. Our ability maybe to name things slows down. But in dementia, the link between visual input and memory is disrupted, and the brain doesn't seem to understand fully what it's seeing. Sometimes what could help here is to literally call out at the item as you hand it over, here's your pen, and keep the surroundings as uncluttered and predictable as possible. Careblazer, quick interruption. If you are watching this between December 3rd and December 10th, our Care Collective program is open for enrollment with special holiday time bonuses that are not available any other time of year, including access to our upcoming workshop in January so you can start the year strong and set yourself up for the best caregiving year yet. The open enrollment is through December 10th, and anyone who joins by December 5th also will get a bonus of a private one-on-one consultation with me. Everything you need to know is in the description below this video. If you are someone looking for more support, now is the best time. All right, back to your video. All right, let's see if you have experienced any of these less common visual perceptual changes that happen in dementia. Number one, we've talked about it a lot on the channel, visual hallucinations, which means that the person sees something that is not actually there. However, their brain is showing that it is there. So in normal aging changes, we can often experience something called visual illusions, meaning we are misinterpreting what is seen. We might, you know, be walking into a dark room and we see a clump of something on the bed, and we might think our dog is lying on the bed, but as we get closer, we realize it's just the comforter clumped up. That's more of an example of maybe a change that would happen in normal aging. However, in dementia, their brain is often producing things that are not even there. So they might walk into the bedroom and nothing is on the bed, and it could even be perfectly made, and they might see a dog on the bed. Their brain is actually seeing the dog on the bed. That's why we never recommend to argue or correct the person with dementia when they have visual hallucinations, because when you say it's not there, it's actually not true. It is there in the person with dementia's brain. They are seeing it. Something that's even less common is something called motion blindness. Some people with dementia lose the ability to detect motion. So it might look like cars are at a standstill, even though they're actually moving, which can make things like crossing the road dangerous, and driving, not to mention driving. In normal aging, our ability to detect motion might decline slightly, but we can still recognize something is moving. In motion blindness, in dementia, that is gone entirely. They can't tell that it's still moving. Another less common visual change is something called simultaneous agnosia, complicated mouthful. But basically what that means is that the person can only focus on one part of a visual scene at a time. They might see the plate, not the utensils. They might see one person in the group, not the rest of the people in the group. In normal aging, visual scanning might slow down. So it might take a person longer to take in everything in their surroundings. However, their brain is still able to take it all in. When we're talking about this in dementia, the person is literally only capable of taking in one part of a visual scene at a time. So as you can imagine with some of these visual changes, even though the person with dementia is experiencing vision difficulty, this is why changing their glasses, their prescription, often doesn't seem to help, because it's not actually the vision, it's neurological. It's the brain that's impacting how they're perceiving the world. So literally the eyes could be fine, but the brain's image processing centers are not. Okay, that's a lot of information. So let's talk about actually what you can do if you suspect that your loved one with dementia does have some visual changes. Number one, use high contrast colors where you can, with dishes, toilet seat covers, colored tape on door frames, anything to set apart what you want them to focus on. Simplify the environment. Remove clutter can help them focus their attention. Possible simple, clear, easy to read labels on highly frequently used drawers. Improve lighting. Even bright, even lighting can help reduce shadows, which can be misinterpreted as people, animals, holes. Night lights and hallways can be helpful. There's so many different things that we can do to try to help make our environment easier and better for our loved ones to navigate. In terms of like the specific things you can do, this is commonly what we talk about inside of our Care Collective program with members who are going through it right now. So if you're somebody who's looking not only for information, but some amazing connection with other people to get ideas and support, share tears, share laughs, I encourage you to check out our Care Collective program. The link to that is in the description below. And I will be back, as always, next week with another video. I am sending you so much love, Careblazer. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says thank you very much.